but the values do, in the sense that you are an investor, it's not a trader. You create an industry, a laborer comes and gives you the value of his labor, and for that labor you give him something in commodity. So that is the trickiest part, the most difficult part to handle and balance things. What should be the value of that labor, and why should it that be? You know, that is the most tricky part involved in this. But anyway, through the marketing principles, automatically some values come to be established. Sometimes these values are not free values. So there are elements of robbery and stealing also join hands with the simple exchange of values, and the matter becomes complicated. A rich man, for instance, has the government on his side, and bribing the officers, he can acquire a sort of power where that power is used to help him extort cheap labor from people, not for the tax, genuine taxes. So the misapplication of government's power makes the things complicated, and sometimes in a society this system becomes the order of the day. That was the time when, unfortunately for the rest of the world, Marx was born. And he inherited that system, and to him everything was, with reference to such a system, anything else was perhaps not possible for him. So he saw the world in this distorted shape, that where the power of church, the power of state, all went into league with these criminals who bought people's values, not with the exchange of commodities, but just the values, for commodities which were much smaller than the real values. So that is another sort of bargain, where commodities don't change hands, the values do. Now comes hiba. In hiba too, on the one side there is value and on the other a commodity. But there is no coercion and no outside compulsion, and no creative work involved either. No labor is involved, yet the values change hand. In one way it is commodity, solid material commodity, in the other way it is an unseen value which can only be felt by superior powers of mind and heart, but cannot be described. Hiba means you part with something material and exchange it with love, with gratitude, with nearness in mind and heart of someone whom you hold dear. Now this is the most ethereal part of transactions, hiba, and stand highest in the tree of transactions. I started with the more material ones, at the lower and lowest rung of human beings, and gradually rose and brought you to this level. Hiba is the only value, only contact, which can be had between man and God. So man was prepared gradually through a long history of teaching him and educating him and defining his values to a state where he was ready to give hiba to God. That is, to part with his material earnings for some ethereal values which are not palpable, which cannot be touched, which cannot be defined in color, in smell or anything. Only you know that you have become happy. You know that someone else is looking at you with greater love now, and he is accepted. In other transactions which I mentioned, if you part with your something and it is returned to you, it makes you unhappy. It makes you happy because you have received one value and that thing is returned to you. But in hiba, it is the other way around. If it is returned, then you are hurt. Apparently, the matter with which you wanted to part has been returned to you. Bheda is not accepted. But instead of being happy, receiving something tangible, palpable, you can touch and use and consume, you become so deeply, you know, mortified and sad about it. Why? Because you know the value you wanted in return for this to you was more valuable. That is love of the other party concerned. When he returns this, then no deal has been finalized. That is to say, because the deal is cancelled, this is why you are so sad. And in this deal, one thing is real and the other thing is real only to one person. As far as the rest of the society is concerned, it is nothing. I give something to you, present, that is present and heba, the one and the same thing. Now, what have I gained? I have lost. But if I had retained that thing, I couldn't be as happy as when I have parted with it. So obviously, still I am acting selfishly. But in a more refined sense of selfishness, not an ordinary beastly sense of selfishness. Because I have been refined, my values have been promoted into more ethereal world, so my transactions also acquire an ethereal sense. This is what heba is. And this is why the only relationship of give and take between man and God could be that of heba and nothing else. But sometimes this is referred to as tijara by Allah. Tijara in the sense that in heba, the other value is not predetermined and guaranteed. You can go on giving heba to some arrogant, king or, some officer. He may receive it and may not return that value to you in form of love. So heba is always uncertain. And the value remains undetermined. How much will be paid back to you? It's just a question which can never be defined in any terms of figures. But Allah has guaranteed you, underwritten, that if you give hiba to me, I am going to pay back to you, by so many factors, and more and more and more and more and so on. So in that way it becomes also a tijara, where your return of value has been positively underwritten and guaranteed 100% and more. But it doesn't mean that in return for that you are given a commodity like you exchange commodities with human beings. But it also may mean that when actually you are returned something, not only in love, but also in real commodities by God. And that is also one of the reasons why the word tijara is used, while the actually what is being discussed is hiba. You present something to Allah, attahiyatu lillahi, that is hiba. And that is what is required of man. But Allah calls it tijara, because Allah returns to you that commodity many times actually in the form of a commodity, not only in the form of love. So if the exchange of value was only in the form of love, then that relationship of give and take between man and God would be only called hiba. In essence, this is exactly how we stand. But out of mercy from Allah, this has been given a new connotation of tijara as well, that is trade. Allah says, what are the factors of trade? Number one, as I have described already, commodity against commodity. And a guarantee.